Does all this specialization, the individual attention, the coaching, does it actually help the kid?
It depends. There is some evidence that it doesn't. We cite a study that UCLA did a few years ago. They surveyed something like 286 college athletes and figured out that 86% of them played two or three sports growing up. So, you know, and some coaches, Urban Meyer has been on record saying he looks for kids who played different sports growing up.
But it cuts both ways.
Right.
I mean, there's no doubt that this really, really intense specialization has brought with it unprecedented access to a level of coaching and training that I certainly didn't have, that even elite kids didn't have as recently as 10 years ago, let alone 20 or 30. The question is, at what cost?
Yeah, speaking of that access.
Let's talk about the cost. It's at $15 billion a year.
Is it accessible to, you know, quote unquote, regular people? Or what are the financial restrictions?
Sean can speak to this in greater detail, but increasingly less so. And that's one of the most alarming things about the rapid professionalization of youth sports.
Yeah, I mean, quick number. If you're 41% of families that make $100,000 or more participate in youth sports. If you do 25 or less, it's 19%. So cuts it in half. So there's data out there that shows it's a pay-to-play system.
I mean, how much does it cost a year? If your kid is a really good baseball player, soccer player, and you're paying for individual hitting instructor or something, what is this going to run you?
Really, the sky's the limit. It depends almost entirely on how much you want to put into it. I mean, the kid on the cover of the new issue of Time is Joey Arachi, and he goes by the nickname Joey Baseball. He has more than 24,000 followers on Instagram right now. His father spends north of $30,000 a year on his career. Figure private coaches are at least 100 an hour, and many are doing it not just for one skill, but a range of them. You could have a fielding instructor, a pitching coach, a hitting coach.
I feel like the end game here should be fun, personal development, all of those things. But is there another end game? Is it the college scholarship? Is it going pro?
Yeah, I think the scholarship drives a lot of it. Now, you know, you talk to families, and in fairness, the Joey Baseball, for example, the kid looks like he's having fun. He makes friends. There's great experiences and memories to be had playing youth sports at this level if you don't make it to the pros. But on the flip side, the odds of getting a college scholarship, something like 2% of high school athletes actually play Division I. So the odds are against you. So if you're banking on that, which surveys show a lot more parents are, that's a dangerous proposition.